Thank you. Good morning, Prince of Peace Community Church and Healing Center. It is a blessing to see you this morning. Good morning to our pastor, Reverend Dr. Jendayo K. Grady and Queen First Lady Kelly Grady. We're so excited this morning. I'm telling you, we're so excited because this is Women's Day 2021, Women's Day at the Prince of Peace Community Church and Healing Center. We have had such a fantastic, dynamic season of Queens, the theme, Queens That Praise, coming from Exodus 15, verses 19 through 21, where Miriam turned around and saw that God had closed the Red Sea on the enemy, and they had escaped on dry land, crossed the Red Sea on dry land, and Miriam started to praise God, and then all the women started to praise God, and the word said that the men joined in right after that. God is amazing, and he's good, and he's a worthy God to be praised. He has blessed the queens of this church. This season has been so dynamic, just teaching us the importance of praise, teaching us what it means to God when we humble ourselves and surrender unto praise, and how God inhabits our praises. And I'm telling you, we're living in a time right now that we need God every step of the way. So queens, get excited this morning. Make sure that you celebrate today. Make sure that you use those heart emojis, those clapping hands, those praising hands. Make sure that you celebrate what God has done in your life. I know personally how much I've grown through this season. The whole purpose of God taking us through these processes of seasons is because he wants us to be closer to him. It teaches us to know more about who he is and to know more about who he is to us. So to God be the glory and to God be the praise. And I know the queens are looking beautiful this morning, even virtually. I can see you from here that you are looking beautiful this morning and ready to celebrate. To carry us through to the end is going to be Apostle Andrea M. Foster. She is the guest preacher for today. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So I'm so excited for the fire that is to come, and the word, which is the word. The fire is the word that is coming to us for such a time as this. Come on, queens that praise. This is your day. Celebrate God and celebrate yourself for all that he's done for us, how he has continued to deliver us from the hands of the enemy, how he has blessed us in spite of ourselves, how he has blessed us continually in this environment. God is good, and he's a good God to be praised. So let's have some church this morning. Let's celebrate Women's Day, and let's all come together understanding that God has done great things for us. And greater is still yet to come. Come on, queens that praise. As I look back over my life,
are not consumed, because thy compassion fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faith.
Shackles and you set me free. How you made a way out of no way. Turn my darkness into day. You've been my joy in the time of sorrow. Oh, for my tomorrow. Peace in the time of storm. Strength when I'm weak and warm.
I can never repay you, Lord, for what you've done for me. How you loose my shackles and you set me free. How you made a way out of no way. Turn my darkness into day. You've been my joy in the time of sorrow. Oh, for my tomorrow. Peace in the time of storm. Strength when I'm weak and worn.
You've been, Lord, you've been so faithful.
Even though sometimes I didn't do what you wanted me to do.
Good morning, saints. I will be reading Psalms 148 from the English Standard Version. Won't you please read along with me? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all his angels, and praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens and you waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created, and he established them forever and ever. He gave a decree and it shall not pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, you great sea creatures and all deeps, fire and hail, snow and mist, stormy wind, fulfilling his word, mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, beasts and all livestock, creeping things and flying birds, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth, young men and maidens together, old men and children, let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His majesty is above earth and heaven. He has raised up a horn for his people. Praise for all his saints, for the people of Israel who are near to him. Praise the Lord. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his word.
Praise is what I do when I wanna be close to you. I lift my hands in praise.
Praise the Lord, Prince of Peace, Queens. Happy Women's Day. Among my favorite scriptures is Psalms 27:13. I would have fainted if I had not believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And praise God, I have seen God in my life. Have a wonderful Women's Day, Prince of Peace, Queens.
This is one of my favorite scriptures because it brings me comfort when I begin to feel overwhelmed by a problem presented before me. I will be reading Psalm 127, verse 1 through 2 from the King James Version. Except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waketh but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. That is the end of the reading. I hope that you are able to find comfort in it too.
Good morning, saints, and praise the Lord, everyone. This morning I come before you with a testimony of thankfulness, just being thankful for what God has done for me. Thankful for the times he's been with me. When I've called upon him, he's answered me. That, you know, I've never been homeless. I've never been hungry. I've just never been without the things that I really needed in life to move from day to day. God has always provided, and for that, I'm eternally grateful. I look at my family, I'm thankful. All of my siblings are still with me. My mother, who will be 102 next month, is still here with me in her right mind, moving and doing for herself. That is a testimony in itself to the goodness of God. For that, I say thank you. You know, your life doesn't have to be the one of woes, one of hunger or helplessness. It can be one of just life itself. Life itself can stretch you thin. And in those times, you have to know who to call upon. And I call upon the Lord because he's my greatest supporter. He's the one who's always there with me to answer my prayers. When I think I can't go one step further, he's right there, illuminating my path, showing me the way, taking me by the hand, never leaving me alone. I know that there is someone always there with me, a shoulder I can lean on, someone I can depend on. And so, you know, I just thank God. And so I leave you with this. When times get heavy and you don't know what to do, you don't know which way to go, just call upon the Lord. Look to the hills from which cometh your help, for your help truly comes from the Lord. For that I'm eternally grateful. So I just leave you with this. Glory be to God. That's what you'll always hear me say. Glory be to God. Good morning, saints, and welcome, everyone. Let us all bow our heads in prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this morning with thanksgiving and joy in our hearts. Lord God, we come before you this morning with a praise on our lips, thanking you, Father, for bringing us full circle to witness once again another Women's Day here at Prince of Peace. Lord God, we don't take this lightly, nor do we take it for granted. For there are some that were here last year that are not here this year. So, Lord God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for another opportunity to just stand, to honor, and to give you praise. We thank you, Father, for your goodness and your mercy as we strive to be the church with open doors, as we strive to be true to the mantle that you have placed upon us. Father God, we thank you for each participant in the service this morning, each one that took time out of their day to help make this Women's Day unlike any other, not something they had to do, but something they chose to do. We thank you, Father, for all of the saints who decided to worship with us this morning. We thank you, Lord God, because in this time of virtual church, their choices are unlimited, but they chose Prince of Peace, and for that, we are so grateful. We ask, Lord God, that you just bless them, watch over them. Give them blessings beyond measure, Lord God. Father, we thank you for the blessings you have bestowed upon all of us, those seen and unseen. But Father, for some, these are hard times.
So we ask, Lord God, that you lift them up, relieving them of the stress and strain they face every day. We ask, Lord God, that you make living just a little bit easier. We come this morning praying healing for those that are sick and financial stability for those who are facing financial difficulties. Father God, we thank you for the head of the women's ministry, the Reverend Brenda Gallion, the visionary for the Prince of Peace Women's Day 2021. We thank you, Lord God, for placing this woman of God over this ministry for such a time as this. One who never says never, but endeavors with the help of the Lord to make visions come to fruition. One who looks at technology as just one more hill to climb. Lord God, we pray blessings upon her. We ask that you keep her, that you never leave her, Father God, that you satisfy her every need. For that we say thank you. And then, Lord God, we thank you for the shepherds we have placed over this house called Prince of Peace, the Reverend Dr. Jendayo Grady, a man who teaches and preaches the word of God with clarity, breaking it down so that everyone understands, leaving no one in the dark. Bless him, Father. Keep him strong. Satisfy his every need, leaving nothing undone. Lord God, we ask that you bless the First Lady of this house, Mrs. Kelly Grady. We thank you, Father God, for her exemplary spirit of love and devotion to you, to her husband, to her family, and to the church. We ask that you bless her and keep her, letting no hurt, harm, or danger befall her. Then, Father, we pray for children everywhere. Shield them, Lord God, from the virus as they return to school. Shield them, Lord God, from stray bullets as they play inside and outside of their home. Keep them safe, Lord God, as only you can, letting children be children. Keep them focused as they endeavor to learn in these challenging times. Now, Father God, we come praying for the speaker of the hour, the Apostle Andrea Foster. As she comes forth with the word, we ask, Father, that you bless her in a very special way. We ask, Lord God, that you take control. Fill her up with your words, Lord God, until it spills over with power and conviction, touching all of those under the sound of her voice. For you are a good God, a mighty God, omnipotent and omnipresent, a God that cannot fail. So, Father, we come before you this morning, laying all of our prayers and concerns at your feet. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen.
I'll be committed to you. I'll never leave you. Nothing in this world could make me walk away. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what you face, you won't be lonely. Because forever
in me, loves the Jesus in you, so easy. Good morning, Prince of Peace family. Pastor Grady and guest speaker, Apostle Foster, and all our queens. I will be reading from Psalm 116. I love the Lord because he heard my cry and my prayers. Because he has inclined his ear to me, therefore I will call upon him as long as I live. The pains of death surrounded me, and the pains of hell laid hold of me. I found trouble and sorrow. Then I called upon the name of the Lord. O Lord, I implore you, deliver my soul. Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Yes, our God is merciful. The Lord preserved the sincere. I was brought low, and he saved me. Return to your rest, O my soul, for the Lord has dealt bountifully with you. For you, O God, have delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, and my feet from falling. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. This is my testimony. This is my prayer. Amen and amen.
Go through because praise is what I do.
Praise comes from Psalm 34, verses 1 through 3. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Amen.
Good day, or as I like to say, God's Day. In honor of Women's Day, I'd like to share with you one of my favorite scriptures taken from Proverbs chapter 31, verses 25 and 26. She is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs without fear of the future. When she speaks, her words are wise, and she gives instructions with kindness. Now this scripture reminds us of how God will guide you, strengthen you, cause you to grow in wisdom and prepare you for the days ahead, because you are covered in strength and worthy of honor and respect. There's no need to be afraid of the future because God has already handled it and he has taken care of it all. Be blessed, queens and kings.
And saints, good morning, queens, queens that praise. I like the scripture in the 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 10, which reads, "But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me was not in vain. but I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet, not I, but the grace of God, which was with me. And as I go to the Old Testament and I think about all of those queens that praised him, I think about Deborah and I think about Esther and I think about Rahab and over in the New Testament, Mary Magdalene and the woman with the issue with the alabaster box and then Anna that was in the temple just praising and worshiping God. I move forward and I think about Harriet Beecher Stowe and I think about Sojourner Truth and I think about her poem, Ain't I a Woman? And then there's that line in that poem that says this, that little man in black there, he says women can't have as much rights as men because Christ wasn't a woman. Where did your Christ come from? From God and a woman. Man had nothing to do with him. And this is what I'm talking about, queens that praise. And then I think about my mother. A queen that praised God all of her life, not just my mother, but many of my elders, my auntie, my grandmother, and so forth. But they all showed me what it meant to praise God. And they all let me know that I was a queen, because once I knew God, I became a queen. And once I became a queen, I can't go wrong, because once I'm a queen that praises, I know that I have everlasting grace and I have everlasting mercy. I am a queen that praises.
Queens that praise. It was in the 1990s. I was going through the most difficult time in my life, and I knew that I needed to know God more. I knew that I needed to know the Word more, and I started to seek Him in ways that I had never done before. And this is the scripture, Isaiah 40, verses 28 through 31, when God started to speak to me in a way that gave me the strength I needed and allowed me to understand that hope was in front of me because He was with me. And it was Isaiah 40 verses 28 through 31, and it reads like this. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases their strength. Even youth shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they that wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Thank you, God, for the power that you gave me in your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord, Prince of Peace, family, and friends. We are so glad to have you here with us today. And today, I'd like to congratulate Reverend Brenda Galleon for orchestrating another successful Women's Day service. And I also like to thank all the queens that assisted in any way, because we are the queens that praise. Amen. And also, right now, it's giving time. Yes, this is the time in our service that we give back and honor God with our giving. Yes, our giving is a way of praising and worshiping God. Amen. And we thank you for your giving because of your tithes and offerings. They bless not only Prince of Peace, but they bless the entire community. And we appreciate that. Our next screen will show you how you can give electronically or through the mail. And remember, God loves a cheerful giver. Amen and amen. Please enjoy the rest of the service.
Let me hear you say bless, bless, bless. In the morning, in the noonday, in the nighttime, we're blessed, bless, 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 bless. We're blessed, we're blessed, we're blessed. Since thou hast walked uprightly as a light in a dark land, since thou hast placed in thy heart all the Lord's command. He set the up of nation and got thy enemies away. He's standing up within thee. So let me hear you say, we're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the fields. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty must cease. For the devil.
Smile again.
Good morning, Prince of Peace Christian Community Church and Healing Center. God bless you this morning. Thank you so much for the privilege to connect by cyberspace for this Women's Day as we celebrate the queens that praise. I want to thank God for Pastor Grady and Lady Grady and for your gracious invitation to come and to share a word from the Lord. We pray that as things begin to calm down, that we will be able to connect in person, and it will be a privilege and an honor to greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. This morning, for the time that is mine, I want to read this your scripture in your hearing, Exodus chapter 15, verses 19 through 21, and I want to read from the New Living Translation of the Word of God. Here begins the reading of God's Word. When Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and charioteers rushed into the sea, the Lord brought the water crashing down on them. But the people of Israel had walked through on dry land. Then Miriam the prophet, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine and led all the women in rhythm and in dance. And Miriam sang a song, "I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. He has thrown both horse and rider into the sea." Amen for the reading of God's word. And this morning, our subject is, "And the queens said," and the queens said. Let us pray. God, we thank you for another opportunity to be your servant, to be your mouthpiece, to declare your word. God, I fully understand that I have absolutely nothing to say unless the preacher comes. So send the Holy Spirit with power and authority and conviction. May some woman today realize that she is a queen in your sight. And may all the queens understand that prayer is their power to become what you have ordained for them to be. Thank you for this branch of Zion, Prince of Peace family. Now, God, in these sacred moments, allow your Holy Spirit to connect us virtually as we go into the Word of God. Thank you, God, in advance for the blessing that your Word shall be in Jesus' name. Hide me, use me, however you see fit, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And the queens said, "What makes a woman a queen?" And I think that's a good place to start for us to understand praise. I believe it is critical that we understand who we are as women of God, that we were created in the image of God and in the likeness of God. And when God created woman, he didn't make a mistake. So we stand here in 2021 celebrating women of God. And in our celebration, I want us to understand that we don't praise because life is perfect. We don't praise because we've got everything together. We don't praise because we're in perfect health. We don't praise because no one ever gets a divorce. We don't praise because no one's ever been abused. We don't praise because everyone reached their occupational goals. We don't praise because our children are everything that we prayed for them to be. We don't praise because our young people are walking in the fullness of who God has called them to be. We don't praise because we're perfect. We don't praise because we feel well all the time. We don't praise because we know everything. We don't praise because we have all the financial wherewithal that we desire. We don't praise because our families are perfect. We don't praise because life has always been good to us and that we've walked with a silver spoon in our mouth. We don't praise because of what we have. We praise because of who God is. And so as we look at this theme, Queens That Praise, this morning, I pondered the question first, what makes a queen? Some would say that a queen is in a deck of cards on a board game. Some would say that a queen refers to a place or a thing at its best,
and the most beautiful of its kind. Some would say that a queen is a wife of a king. Some would say that it's the sovereignty of womanhood. Some would say a queen is one who rules over a monarchy in her own right. Even some would say a queen is a mature female, especially one kept for even breeding animals in the animal kingdom. Some would say a queen is a fully developed reproducing female in a colony of bees. Some would say that the most powerful piece permitted to move any number of unoccupied squares in a horizontal or vertical or diagonal direction on a chessboard is a queen. Some would say a city is a queen like Paris. It's regarded as the queen of all cities because of its preeminence over other cities. Some would say a queen is a woman who rules a country or is married to a king. Some would say that a queen is a young girl who moves into womanhood and becomes the very best that she can be, very important and very successful in her desired goals. But my declaration today is that a queen is one who has stepped in the fullness of her womanhood, who knows her worth and her accountability to the God who created her, who knows who she is and whose she is. To me, a queen is one who is a female believer in Christ Jesus, one who understands that women were not an afterthought to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And I submit to you that because Christ is our King, it is He that establishes us in our queendom. And so we lift up during this woman season, queens that praise. Well, we look at a biblical model this morning of one who was never called a queen, but was the queen of praise. One who was not perfect based on her journey. One who stood beside Moses and Aaron. We're talking about the prophetess Miriam. And when I think of Miriam, I think of her journey and how in the midst of the journey, she discovered who she was and whose she was to Yahweh. Miriam was the eldest child of Amram and Jochebed and the sister of both Aaron and Moses. We never read of her having a husband, though she lived a well-established life. And we have already seen in the story of Jochebed that the part Miriam played in getting Moses' own mother to be his nurse after Pharaoh's daughter found him in the river. Though Miriam failed at another time of her life when she and Aaron rebelled against the authority of Moses, we consider her role as a leader of praise among God's people. Miriam is called in the King James Version a prophetess, but in the original language, Miriam is called the inspired one. She is identified as the sister of Aaron, one who was raised up by God and inspired by the Spirit to proclaim the will and the purpose of God. We see Miriam in action at the Red Sea, proclaiming and singing about the power and the faithfulness of God. God had caused the rivers to roll back and stand up and allow the Israelites to pass through on dry ground. While pursuing the Egyptians, they were drowned in the waters as the waters came tumbling down upon them. When they were safely on the other side, Miriam led God's people into a time of praise to Yahweh. Miriam knew God was worthy of praise. She had experienced his supernatural acts among his people, both before and after leaving Egypt. God had protected them during the terrible plagues that God had delivered them from. God had delivered them from Pharaoh's army by rolling back the waters of the Red Sea so they could escape. Miriam is reminded of all of the mighty acts that God had committed unto them. God provided all of their physical needs, including food, as they were traversing through the wilderness. As a prophet, she knew God's desire to communicate with his people. And in gratitude and in thanksgiving, Miriam encouraged the people to respond to the Lord, not only for his mercy and his blessing, but just to acknowledge him as God. When some called the song, some call her song, the song at the sea. And it is one of the oldest musical offerings given during the Exodus from Egypt. And the text designates Miriam as the leader of prophetic praise. The declaration of her songs to Yahweh to celebrate what he is about to do in the parting of the Red Sea. Her prophetic praise and song challenges the stereotypes about the women in ancient Israel and their leadership. They were singing war songs and militaristic battle hymns, and they were the author of the dance. If we look beyond the cultural prejudices, we would probably find that there were some women who had to fight in battle when there were shortages of men killed in war. Because Miriam was called a prophet, along with her unquestionable leadership of the victory here, along with her brothers in Exodus chapter 15, that the Israelites were familiar and quite relaxed with female authority, even though that may not be the case today. Because every time you see Miriam's name, usually she is grouped with Moses and Aaron, suggesting to us that they were a leadership team of three. When Miriam began to sing these war songs and these battle hymns, they were prophetic statements that were hot off the wire that God had been with them all along. And when they got to the Red Sea, she knew that God would not leave them, that God would make a way somehow. Prophetic praise is when we begin to praise God for who he is. And when we are in the midst of the Red Seas of life, prophetic praise is speaking for knowledge of who God is into our situation before we see the resolution of what we have prayed for. Prophetic praise is a praise that speaks to that. It's about what's about to happen, and that we take the time to praise God in the midst of what we do not see, to prophetically speak into our situation and to say to God, however long it takes, I'm going to praise you anyhow. Prophetic praise means I'm going to celebrate you now before you bless me with the answer, before you bless me with the healing, before you bless me with the comfort, before you bless me with the financial blessing, before you send a new job. I'm going to prophetically praise my way into what I desire to see in you. Miriam's offering of praise and musical giftings motivated the soldiers while they were in battle to never forget the promises of Yahweh and Yahweh's record. She sang during the upheavals in the wilderness of the Red Sea, and she shared her leadership with her brother, knowing the battle plan, knowing what they were about to come up against. She wanted to be an encouragement to the men as they were preparing to face this Red Sea before them. She took a tambourine in her hand and began to sing and dance before the Lord. And the fire of the singing and her dancing began to attract other women to join in on the praise team and the dance, worshiping God in spirit and in truth. In song, Miriam recalls his mighty acts, and the women began to join her. When one sister praises and one sister reflects on the mighty power and acts of God, it becomes contagious. And even if we don't understand what all the praise is about, it's electrifying, and it draws other women to come and to tag team with us and enter into praise until the praise becomes a part of who we are. Sometimes, sisters, we have to begin to grab another sister even when she doesn't want to come, and show her how to praise God before she sees her situation answered, to show her that God has already had a good track record in our lives, and that God has already done exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could ask or imagine, according to the power that works in us. Sometimes we got to reach out and grab another queen. We got to bring her in and teach her how to praise. in joyful ministry unto the Lord. Even the psalmist declares in 100 verse 2 and verse 4, it says, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with thanksgiving. Enter his courts with praise and be thankful unto him and to bless his name. We enter into true worship first by thanking God for what God has already done. Thanking God that with us he has a good track record. Thanking God that he has blessed us more than we could ever think or imagine. To thank God because he's God. Thank him that he's our God. Thank him that he's already watched over us and he is protecting us. And then we can begin to praise him for who he is and how he has made himself known unto us. We look at the scriptures and we note that praise is active. We can't just think of praise. We have to be demonstrative and we have to act out our praise, whether it's lifting a hand or a tear streaming down or a dance in the middle of your situation. Praise is active. And the more active our praise, the more the enemy begins to really walk away from us, because the enemy cannot be in the midst of a praise situation. And so we think of the things that God has done. Praise demands a sacrifice of ourselves. When we review the catalog of praiseworthy acts of what God has already done, then the sacrifice, my queens, is we praise when we're hurt. We praise when we're sick and we're in pain. We may not be able to get out of the bed, but we can still articulate something from our lips that, God, I still believe that you are a healer. We praise in the midst of grief, even if the tears are crisscrossing underneath our chin. We still can praise God because we know that soon and very soon, comfort will come. We praise, my queens, when we're broke and the bills are due, because we know he still owns cattle on 1,000 hills. We praise, my queens, when we're alone and we're not lonely. We praise God because he's never forgot about us. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. The Hebrew writer in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15, tells us to offer up the sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is the fruit of our lips giving thanks to his name. We must give a praise from our lips. We need to praise in the midst of our situation. We have to understand that praise is a sacrifice. I might be hurting, but the sacrifice is to praise anyhow. When I'm going through, the sacrifice is for me to forget about my situation and be reminded of who God is. And we have to give energy to our praise. God enjoys the praise. And in fact, when we're in the midst of difficult situations and we can still praise God, it ignites something in the heart of God. He commands us to praise. And so we should always pray continually to let God know that my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. And like Miriam, we can dance, we can sing, we can play the instruments before the Lord. Now, I don't know if we can play like the Levites, but I know that we can articulate a song from our heart. We can use a Hammond organ. We can use a tambourine, but there ought to be some kind of song exuding from our soul and our spirit. God is restoring the praise in the church in this end times. True praise is a part of worship that is often being neglected or misunderstood. It's easy for us to praise without understanding. Just throw a hand in the air, clap your hands, jump and shout, even do a little boogie, but we have no understanding of our praise. Humanity frequently becomes spectators in our worship experiences, and oftentimes find it more comfortable to participate passively in worship services, waiting on the worship leader to be our conductor, to tell us when to lift our hand, to tell us when to stomp our feet, to tell us when to clap our hands. But if we spend time with God all week long, when we get to the gathering, when we assemble together as the word of God tells us to, when we get to the house of God, we should enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise and be thankful unto him and to bless his name. Without a worship leader, without a choir, without a director, because we have spent time all week with God praising the name of the Lord who has kept us, praising the name of the one who provided for us, who heals us, who comforts us, who releases favor upon us, who has kept his word and his promises. And then when we come together, when all of us have been praising him all week long, there will be a combustible praise that won't require anything of a worship leader, because we're entering in with such joy bells ringing in our souls. God wants us to start praising him now, since that is what we're going to do in eternity anyhow. And I love the analogy of my dear friend, Reverend Stephen Hurd, in his amazing book, The Seed of David. He talks about the difference between praise and worship. And he talks about praise is like a house, usually owned by its inhabitants, and it's furnished for permanent residency. It's a place where God wants to live within you and I. And then on the flip side, Reverend Hurd talks about a hotel, and he says it's owned by an outsider that intends to capitalize from the profits of the visitation without any intention of a permanent stay. And I love that analogy, because oftentimes we have replaced our house, our tabernacle, for a hotel, that we have entered into his presence with a check-in, check-out mentality. We check in for the call to worship, and we check out after the benediction. But we must begin to furnish this home, this tabernacle, with the Lord, so that he might feel comfortable abiding in us and with us and through us. But we have to check, are we a house or are we a hotel? Are we only interested in a quick visitation? Or are we building day by day a foundation necessary for God to live in us? Sometimes we wait to Sunday to praise the Lord, but we have learned in this pandemic how to enter into his presence and worship for ourselves. During this pandemic, we have learned how to praise without a Hammond organ. We've learned how to praise without any musical instruments. We've learned how to create our own hymnology and musicology straight off the wire out of our time spent with God. We have learned how to dig within and find a place of gratitude and adoration for him who has kept us. We've learned in this season that we can praise God for who he is. God has kept us. God has comforted us in the midst of our grief. God has given us hope when the situation looks hopeless. God has provided for us and built a hedge of protection around us. God has kept us when we couldn't keep ourselves. God has given us peace when others are afraid. God is the one who is our redeemer and our sustainer and our hope for tomorrow. Where what we have learned during the pandemic is that we begin to build this house that Reverend Hurd talks about, that we can no longer live in a hotel owned by the world with a check-in and check-out mentality. Like Miriam and the women, we sing to the Lord, for he has triumphant gloriously in our battles and the Red Sea moments of life. And I'm reminded that in the military, every soldier or airman has a battle dress uniform, or what many civilians know as fatigues. It's always worn in daily times of peace for preparedness. A service member never knows when they need to be ready and prepared for battle. A service member never knows, so they practice, they read, they study their field manual. They test and retest to be ready. We, the people of God, have to be prepared in peacetime So when the wars and the battles of life comes, we've already practiced. We've already studied the manual, which is the word of God. And we've been tried and tested time and time again. And we should understand that now we're ready. And the queen said, in the midst of circumstances, I will put on my garment of praise. That's my uniform. In the midst of all that is going on, in the midst of every situation, I will sing in the midst of my troubles. I will trust in what I do not see. And the queen said, I will trust in what I do not see. I will believe that all my help comes from the Lord. The Lord, he is all I need. I will lift up mine eyes to the hills from which cometh my help. The queen said, he is still my shepherd, and I shall not want. I will hold fast to the profession of my faith without wavering, for he who has promised is faithful. And the queen said, I will praise prophetically like Miriam, by praising into my situation, with the knowledge of the Father and his love for me, the promise of the Savior who died for me, and the power of the Holy Spirit that lives in and through and empowers me. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us, my queens, exalt his name together. And the queen said, I will prophetically praise in the midst of my situation, because God will triumphant gloriously. Amen. God bless you, Prince of Peace. I hope to see you real soon.
At the mention of your name, every knee must bow, every tongue confess that you are Lord. Yes, you are. At the mention of your name, every knee must bow, every tongue confess that you are Lord. Yes, you are. 'Cause at the mention of your name, every knee must bow, every tongue confess that you are Lord. Yes, you are. Jesus, you are Lord. Oh.